Hello, my wonderful friends. Today we are looking at the Emerald Square Mall in North Attleboro, Massachusetts. This is a mall I grew up with. It used to be absolutely packed here. I love that Sears sign on that garage, but as we know, Sears is no longer in business. But this mall is massive. It's absolutely massive. I cannot wait to see what it's like inside because I haven't been here in, I want to say, at least a decade. This mall has a lot of parking garages that just kind of sit empty or mostly empty. Now I'm just starting to survey the property here and I'm noticing a lot of excess parking at this point. These parking garages are barely inhabited, barely used. My guess is it's mostly used by employees or during busy seasons and times, but I mean, just looking at the general state of the exterior, it's in need of a power washing. I could say that with certainty. Not everything on it is looking healthy right off the bat. Definitely some rust. I absolutely love the greenage that is taking over that brick there. Although that greenage isn't looking the healthiest, but we are in spring, it is April. And one thing I love about the Macy's exterior of this vintage is that nice marble entrances that they tend to do. I noticed that at a few malls I've been to lately. I feel like even just in my initial observations that the parking lot is not in the best shape, I feel like it could need a little bit of repair. I have seen, you know, some areas where they have patched and repaired it, but it looks like it's going to need some more in the near future. Change is good. Somebody needs to come over and change that sign to be vertical. Again, love that Macy's marble entrance there. It just looks grand and magnificent. And I don't blame the mall as much as I blame the patrons, but I'm noticing like a lot of trash. Too much trash for my liking. Honestly, you guys, it's excruciatingly hot out, so I probably won't be killing myself with the exterior shots today. That's actually what I speculated. I kind of figured they were going to block off the upper floors of the parking garage due to lack of traffic and maybe lack of repairs. So you can see right there, it is blocked off. And again, we're at another section more on the Sears side. And this area is a little bit inhabited. There is a general entrance over there and that's where we're gonna go through. But I wanna take a moment to look at the Sears before we do that. That is just an enchanting looking Sears right there. That entrance that we're gonna take a look at as well is absolutely charming. Very 90s, I'm here for it. But yeah, this, even the sidewalk there is not in the best shape. But let's see this Sears. Let's see if we can see inside. What is that? Do they like block off the walls? Not so sure what that is. Those are slightly vintage ADT boxes, I feel like, over there, marking each side. This guy looks like he's going over to break some stuff. I don't know what he's holding. We cannot see and hear, unfortunately, although oddly it looks like there's some like water damage along that. I don't know if it's cardboard or something that they use to line it so you can't see in. And I'm not tall enough to see above that. I kind of feel like I need to get a drone to start making better mall videos. A little curious what we're going to see, if anything, at the top of these stairs. Oh. Okay. Not a damn thing. My assumption is they close it off to traffic, but they forgot to close off the stairs. Huh. And those markers there, they're pretty weathered by the elements at this point. They're pretty worn down. And there is Sears. There's a beautiful view of that mall sign. I think we gotta go in there. Oh, look at that exit sign. That's pretty weathered too. Absolutely magical. I'd love to see it lit up at night too. I wish I was able to come out here at night right now. Yeah, I just cannot believe it's this hot in the middle of April, 91 degrees. What a heat wave. I think it's like record temperatures.
digging like trash, like a dumpster to find merchandise for the things I liked, and now you can just walk anywhere.
Literally.
You can go to Walmart.
Thank you.
Guys, I was honestly shocked at what I saw in there. I can't wait to go home and edit this video. I think the biggest problem with this mall is its size. It is built to house a lot of stores, and today's mall shoppers don't want that many stores. If this mall was condensed down to one floor, maybe the bottom floor, because there was an issue with the heat rising, then this would be a very manageable mall. I think people would shop here more, but the amount of space that's here is insane. I think that the finishes are so nice. I think there's a lot good in this mall, but there's no way they can repopulate this mall the way it needs to be.